about it, except for Crystal Chronicles, a freaking mobile game. Now here's this. Would you sacrifice for power? Wait, what's this? Last Remnant Remastered. Okay, I thought this looked familiar. I want to switch. Nice.
The children of Hargon, the vile cult that worships destruction, has outlawed the building, cooking, and creation of all things, and captured the builders. All hope seems to be lost until you, a young apprentice builder, manages to escape the clutches of evil. Washed up on the deserted shores of the Isle of Awakening, and with the help of your spirited and mysterious companion, Malroth, it is up to you to doff your mallet and club, unravel the riddles of this land, and defeat the hateful children of Harkon. Travel the diverse islands and discover your true potential as a master builder. There is a land of adventure with many islands offering unlimited building combinations.
This is like Minecraft with the story mode in Dragon Quest.
With more to do and even more to create. Everything in Dragon Quest Builders 2 is much, much bigger. Build huge structures in a larger world with more variety and options than ever before. And with a little help from the eager islanders. The world is humongous, and you'll need your wits about you to get around. Run across open fields and explore ruins, treacherous mines, and spectacular castles. Dive into the watery depths to discover hidden treasures. Climb the highest mountains to catch the sunset, and glide home to rest up for your next day of adventure. But beware. Monsters roam this land and will need to be dispatched with cunning composure. Luckily, accompanying you on your quest is the enigmatic Malroth, an aggressive amnesiac with a fondness for fighting foes. Use powerful attacks on the battlefield to take down monstrous beasts! Work together with your villagers to till soil, plant seeds, and raise a multitude of crops. Be sure to customize the way you build your fields to support the kind of crops you're growing. Harvest anything from the humble cabbage and wheat to tantalizingly tasty tomatoes. Big projects require big, big help.
You and three friends
team up online to build anything you can imagine. Let your creativity run wild!
I might check this out, though.
The only limit is your imagination. So call on your friends and build your fate together! The road you build is paved with peril, young builder. Only you can defeat the children of Hargon. Bring an end to destruction and save the world in Dragon Quest Builders 2!
never gave her Switch. Okay, Dragon Quest XI. Terror Rouge was gonna come here, but I guess now it's official. Oh, so you can play in either 16-bit or modern mode. Darkspawn, what is this, Dragon Age?
I believe in you. I believe in the Luminary. Do not lose heart. Do not look back. Remember, you're the Luminary. We believe in you.
All right. We're going to see some new stuff. I want to see some new stuff. Show me new stuff. Greetings Collective. New indie games. Fear Effects Sedna. Oh, that's right. They're supposed to be doing a remake of the original Fear Effects. Hopefully we can see that tonight. Italian, 1944, Eastern Front. Forgotten Annie, I gotta pick that up, because that looks really good. Coming up next in 2020. With a nice fancy car.
Hello everyone, this is Carolina.
Alberto and Carlos Mastretta.
We're a family of motorsport fans from Mexico, and we're the founders of Original Fire Games.
Over the last few decades, we have seen a fascinating evolution in racing games. And nowadays, you can drive almost any type of car on amazing recreations of the best tracks in the world.
However, we believe it's time to try something different. We want to do this by reviving a style that pioneered racing games decades ago.
So this is coming to Xbox One.
With a classic, sharp arcade look and tactile driving physics, which brings together a whole range of styles and eras of motorsport.
We are delighted to share this moment with you.
And show a sneak preview of our game, which Square Enix Collective will publish in 2020.
Join us for the ride, and see you again soon.
This looks like RC Pro-Am back on the Nintendo. Enter the charming world of motorsport. Plan your pitch strategy. It was kind of like arcade-ish.
Battalion 1944 recaptures the core of classic competitive first-person shooters. You'll need to quickly coordinate strategies with your team on the fly, whilst keeping your movement nimble and your aim precise if you hope to beat out the competition.
See what I mean?
There are multiple game modes for you and your team to dive into. Test your skills in domination, capture the flag, or team deathmatch, and perfect your tactics in the highly competitive.
Like one of those old school World War II shooters.
FaceIt's competitive toolset is fully integrated into the game, bringing world-renowned competitive matchmaking, 1v1s, tournaments, rankings, and leaderboards. Kill enemies, win matches, and rank up to demonstrate your Battalion 1944 prowess and unlock visual customization rewards. Each season will bring challenges for you to complete and medals to unlock, whilst tracking your in-game accomplishments.
So it looks like they're going the live services route with this, but
by in-game leaderboards.
But this isn't any studio. Gonna be like free to play or
offensive in their tracks with the rapid fire PPSH, or take fire with pixel precision with the Mosin Nagant, and a whole host of new weapons just as deadly as their owners. With a range of environments to test your skills in and a variety of weapons at your disposal, play as a team and compete to be top of the leaderboards. Available now on Steam.
1944. I just won't take away any steam from any of those, like the Overwatches or the Battle or the PUBGs, but it's a nice little alternative. It's like a freaking mobile game. Oh, Square Enix music. Ooh, Final Fantasy X. Oh, that's right. They put the Final Fantasy music on Spotify last week. Go and check that out. So that's a reminder, Square Enix music is now available on streaming services. Disney Pixar. So of course we're gonna see some new Kingdom Hearts 3 content. So Cult Wars of Darkness. It's useful. Told ya. It's how'd it go. World Tour. In an awful way. I realize just how necessary I am. Igmar, who are you? Doesn't make a difference to me anyway. I'll just keep playing dumb. The question is, who are you, Bucksword?
Please welcome Naoki Yoshida, producer and director.
Of course, Shadowbringers for Final Fantasy XIV. Online.
Hi guys, my name is Naoki Yoshida, producer and director of Final Fantasy XIV. 今日はですね、すいません、短い時間ですが、僕からはいよいよこの7月2日発売となるファイナルファンタジー14拡張パッケージ第3弾、漆黒のヴィランズの紹介をさせていただきます。
So we'd like to take a little bit of your time to show off Shadowbringers Final Fantasy 14's third expansion pack, which is releasing on July the 2nd.
2013年に新生オルゼア R エルムリボーンが発売されてから、6年が経ちました。なんと世界で累計登録アカウント数1600万を突破し、なんとこのですね、漆黒のヴィランズの発売を前にして有料会員数も過去最高を、更新することができました。これらはすべて 世界中のプレイヤー光の戦士の皆さんのおかげです。この場を借りて改めてお礼申し上げます。
It's been 6 years since the release of A Realm Reborn in 2013, and over the years we have surpassed 16 million total registered users. Plus, we have reached the highest number of active subscribers in history, in its history, before the launch of Shadowbringers. This is all thanks to our players, our Warriors of Light.
Haven't been to check this out, but like, I don't play MMORPGs enough to justify like spending a monthly fee on it. Like, I'll play a free-to-play one, Secret World, but that's about it.
We view Shadowbringers as more than a simple expansion pack, but as a new game filled with volume and gameplay experiences that are comparable to a brand new standalone RPG title.
また新ジョブであるガンブレイカー、それから踊り子、新種族のロスガルとビエラなど、これからファイナルファンタジー14を始める皆さんにも多数の新規の要素が用意されています。
And there are so many new elements in the game for those who have yet to play Final Fantasy 14, including two new jobs, the Gunbreaker and the Dancer, as well as two new playable races, the Frothgar and the Viera.
ぜひファイナルファンタジーシリーズの
最新作として I've been going on Facebook and seeing advertisers for Final Fantasy 11 the last week online and saying you can like reactivate your subscription.
We are excited to bring Shadowbringers as the latest installment in the Final Fantasy franchise for our fans to enjoy, at least until 2020 March 3rd when Final Fantasy 7 Remake comes out.
それではいよいよ7月2日、ローンチとなりますが、この場で世界初公開となる、その漆黒のヴィランズのローンチトレーラーをご覧いただこうと思います。
We are pleased to bring a world premiere of the launch trailer for Shadowbringers releasing on July the 2nd.
Please take a look.
Let's check out Shadowbringers.
The oldest joke in the book. And when, pray tell, did we last have a dark night? Over 100 bleeding years ago, that's when.
In that chaotic no man's land between realms, time and space warp and blend in unexpected ways.What Orange saw was the future.
One good thing about this conference is that, like, damn near everything they showed so far, they've been showing off gameplay footage, and that's what we haven't been seeing from. We didn't see a whole lot of that from Microsoft or Bethesda.
Once the change is wrought.There is no going back.
The eternal light of these creatures has confounded us for nigh on 100 years. For each we have put down, another has risen up in its place, born of the self-same ether relinquished by its predecessor.
That's
all three. Sin eaters are part of Yulmor society. But they must be fed with ether. Living ether.
Truth must be known.
This world's beyond saving.Like those who try to save it. This world has had its fill of heroes.
Looks a lot like Kefka. You know, I know that probably isn't him.
Everything we gave,
was it for? The star was made manifest.
I'm sorry, I can only assume I misheard, but it sounded an awful lot like you were implying both Zodiac and Hydaelyn are not gods, but...
They are gods after a fashion, yes. The eldest and most powerful of primals.
I second. Great. Techland, Dying Light 2, so I assume we're gonna see some Dying Light 2 material. I'm not the biggest fan of zombies, but Dying Light was a fun game. Like, it's one of the few games that actually does something different with the whole zombie formula. I might just check this one out. Bit of an echo to my voice. Yeah, that looks familiar. They had a huge feature on Dying Light last year, but he barely showed us anything at all. It was all over gameplay footage, and to celebrate RPG classics, Bomb and Come West, holy. Oh, sweet, Romancing Saga 3, nice. I used to play the emulated version all the time on computer because they had the English patch. If I'm gonna bring over a fucking translation, that is fucking awesome. Oh my god, they're finally bringing us over. Saga Scar Grace Ambitions. Here's hoping we'll finally get Mana 3. That is freaking awesome. Saga never dies, Saga never ends. Saga lives on. Oh wow. All right, what's next?
Final Fantasy Brave Exvius. Enjoyed by fans the world over, has surpassed 39 million downloads.
Oh wow, never been to a mobile game.
Now, Square Enix proudly presents the international reveal of a new title born from the FFBE universe. War of the Visions, Final Fantasy Brave Exvius. These two titles, FFBE and War of the Visions, will be the pillars of the growing world of Lapis. This is the story of Ardera, a continent of Lapis.
This isn't going to be an actual game or yet never free-to-play mobile game.
Visions. Leonis, ruled by the Red Lion Monarch, possesses the power of visions as well as twin princes. Horn, the great Western kingdom, governed by a policy of peace and its brave and wise king. Fenris, where the king of the savages has organized the barbarian tribes into Ardera's mightiest militant state. Weset, the great eastern kingdom over which reigns its icy despot. Crystal Sanctum, a religious city-state with believers throughout Ardera, founded by one who claims to be God. Each burden with its own dignity. Thus is the curtain drawn on a struggle in which the fate of nations rests. All is for one's homeland. War of the Visions, Final Fantasy.
What kind of game is this gonna be though?
Now in development.
Oh, so it's another smartphone game. I don't know, I heard Brave Exvius was alright as far as free-to-play games go. Here's a Gears of War, Judgment, and Bulletstorm. Okay, I heard rumors about this. Besides all those indies, this is probably going to be the most Western thing that you're going to see in the whole conference. Not actual gameplay footage. There's some guys in a clone or some cloning pot or some shit. Broke down city, so it's probably some post-apocalyptic shit. Thunderstorms and big forests and black stuff. A lot of shooting. Here's some chick with a bald head. Kick-ass music, though. Who's so getting up powers? Outriders. Ah, of course. So, what kind of game is this going to be? It's gonna be like a narrative shooter, a Gears of War type shooter. Who knows? Outriders.net.
Please welcome Sebastian Wojciechowski, studio head. People can fly.
Okay, so I guess we're gonna learn more about it now.
Studio head at People Can Fly, the studio behind Bulletstorm and Gears of War Judgment. Yeah, any Bulletstorm fans in the house? All right. Wow, let me tell you, it feels great to be here and feels amazing to be able to finally announce Outriders.
They also did Painkiller, I think. They could be lying.
I'd like to thank the team at People Can Fly, you guys are amazing, and I know that some of you are watching this live, even though it's 4 a.m. in the morning in Poland, so make a noise for them, please. Thank you.
Yeah, Bulletstorm's a pretty fun game, too.
For the help and support as we work together on this exciting new IP. You know, over the past few years, People Can Fly has grown to over 200 developers and 4 studios across Poland, the UK, and most recently the US, to bring you what is our most ambitious shooter to date. To present more of our vision, I would like to take this moment to introduce a short video from our game director, Bartek Mita. So thanks a lot. More on Outriders this winter. Thank you.
Shooters are in our DNA. It's our passion. And it's what we do. Outriders draws on all our experience from all our previous titles. It's a game we wanted to make for a very long time. We describe Outriders as a dark, modern shooter built with traditional values. By that, I mean we are creating an experience with a strong story that you can enjoy with your friends or on your own. We want to tell a complete story. We are confident we are building a shooter with a powerful gunplay, incredible weaponry, and a hostile new world we want to spend many hours in. It's a game we've had in our heads ever since People Can Fly left Epic Games. Outriders is a 1-2 or 3-player drop-in, drop-out co-op shooter. In our game, you will create your own Outrider and journey across the hostile planet of Enoch in search of the source of a mysterious signal. It's a pretty dark and unforgiving world, and yes, there is a lot more depth to the game, but
I'd like to see more gameplay, but this looks pretty intriguing. And People Can Fly is a good developer as far as us shooters go. Now we're going to see some more stuff that we probably already knew or remakes or re-releases, but hey, I'm enjoying it so far. This already lasted longer than last year's conference, and Square Enix has brought more to the table. Good for them. They learned from last year.
Reincarnation is the foundation of our way of life. We celebrate the lives we've been given and offer up prayers for the next. It is grief of death which shackles the living and causes the dead to stray. Indeed, there is no greater affront to reincarnation. So we turn our grief to joy as we send off the dead. But the souls of those who held back their tears in life still need salvation in death. A duty that falls to the Watchers. The Watchers sever the bonds that tie the lost to this world and send them off to the next. They navigate the emotions of the living and the dead. They prize life above all else. This is the story of one Watcher.
Oh Tony Naki. Fans will have been waiting. At long last, Final Fantasy VIII. Finally! To me, this is the best of the PlayStation era Final Fantasy games. It looks like it's finally going to get a re-release. I remember this came out on the same day as the Dreamcast did in North America. Alright. So finally. Fallen Creator's Grave from in-game footage. Uh-oh, is this? Could this be? Holy shit, it's the Avengers game! Yes! That's what we've been waiting for! Crystal Dynamics presents. Yes, finally! Avengers Day. Iron Man, Thor, Captain America, Black Widow, Hulk. How about those player models, though? Oh well. They look different. How about that Captain America, though? Thor and Iron Man. And Thor's lost some weight since Endgame. It looked like Taskmaster almost. There's in-game footage, but I don't see any game. Well, if we can do all this stuff in the game, though, I'm gonna be excited. The heck? Holy shit, they sunk the helicarrier. The Abomination, different Iron Man suit. Wow. So it starts off, there's some big disaster, and they get praying for it, and there's like, ooh, here's a post credit. There's some coming out of there.
Please welcome Sean Eskai, Creative Director, Crystal Dynamics, and Bill Roseman, Vice President and Creative Director, Marvel Games.
Thank you. We love you. Yeah. Thank you. Thank you, everyone. We are incredibly excited to reveal Marvel's Avengers to the world. A few years ago, Crystal Dynamics and Marvel began collaborating on an original Avengers game, one that combined epic action-adventure with cinematic storytelling. A game where we as players can experience in
both Hawkeye
and co-op what it's like to be Earth's mightiest heroes.
Do I have any true believers in the house?
Yes! Yep.
Awesome. Because you will instantly recognize your favorite superheroes and villains, but you'll also see that they're unique to this game, as this is Crystal's interpretation of these iconic characters.
Our story begins at A-Day, as San Francisco celebrates the opening of the Avengers West Coast headquarters. And the team's custom helicarrier, outfitted with a strange experimental energy source. However, the day turns deadly when an attempt to steal this new technology results in massive destruction. Blamed for the tragedy, the Avengers are outlawed and our heroes disband.
5 years later, a horrific evil threatens the world, and our only
kind of like a different take on Endgame.
Earth's mightiest heroes. You'll play as your favorite Avengers in an all-new original story, showcasing authentic Marvel heroism and humanity. It's about losing what matters to you most and fighting to get it back. Yeah! Yeah!
Yeah, that's what I'm wondering. Where's Hawkeye?
A story about self-acceptance in the face of adversity, about embracing our individual powers and learning that together we are mighty.
Yeah, where is Hawkeye?
You'll lead the team as the legendary super soldier, Captain America. You'll call down the lightning as the Asgardian god of thunder, Thor. You'll channel the anger of scientist Bruce Banner by unleashing the Hulk. You'll gather intel and strike swiftly as the ultimate tactical spy, Black Widow. And finally, you'll blast.
It's like each character's gonna play differently.
Tony Stark, known to the wider world as the Armored Iron Man.
To bring this incredible story to life, we've assembled an all-star cast. I'll let them introduce themselves.
Okay.
So, here we are. Avengers Assemble. Who are you people again?
Hi, I'm Troy Baker, and I play Bruce Banner.
Hi, I'm Jeff Shine, and I play Captain America.
Hi, I'm Travis Willingham, and I play Thor.
Hi, I'm Laura Bailey, and I'm playing Black Widow.
Hi, I'm Nolan North, and I play Tony Stark.
There's certain Nolan North and Troy Baker.
Talked into?
Yeah.
You know, so we'd like to have you play Tony Stark Iron Man. Yeah, yes. You know, everybody always portrays him as this super confident character. And I think it's a mask for him. I think he's one of the most vulnerable guys.
I think Bruce is just such a cool character. A lot of people are really quick to bring out the big green. But I think that Bruce is a super complex character. It's fun, and I've never played him before.
What is very relatable about Natasha is she's extremely capable, but she's at the core, she's human. She's surrounded by...
It looks like you're only going to be able to play as, like, these five guys. Stuff, and she has to but, like, if the I feel like attacks really and gameplay is, like, for me, diverse and interesting enough, then we can have a winner.
One of the things I think is cool about Cap is I never feel like he necessarily wants to be a leader. He accepts that he is. I feel like sometimes the best leaders are the ones who don't necessarily want to be, but they're right for the job.
Having an original story to tell as well, what they've done at Crystal Dynamics is great, so I think everybody's going to be pretty stoked.
The Avengers are at their
Between this and Marvel Ultimate Alliance, it's going to be a... Marvel's bringing their A game when it comes to console video games.
Thanks everybody for joining us. Can't wait for you to be able to play the game, but right now, you don't have to wait for some exclusive content.
Exclusive content? 5 years after A-Day.
Do the Avengers pose a danger to society? That was the question, Bruce. That was the question.
Did you even check the science? Did you check
It was a
science?
Heist. Bruce,
no.
We were outsmarted.
The Terrigen reactor was unstable, and you...
Terrigen reactor? Have you seen the Inhumans?
...before the entire world. So what? We just give up? We didn't give up, Tony. We...
You got Hobo Tony.
At least I can admit that. No, we failed him. We failed him.
Please welcome Scott Amos, Head of Studio, and Megan Marie, Senior Community and Social Media Manager, Crystal Dynamics.
Hello, E3. You've just seen a high-level view of the cinematic and character-driven campaign of Marvel's Avengers. But launch is only the beginning of this adventure.
Marvel's Avengers delivers a narrative over multiple years with exciting new content released at a regular basis.
Like the Avengers, you and your friends are stronger together. You'll assemble into teams of up to four players online.
Oh.
Where you can master extraordinary abilities, where you can customize a growing roster of heroes, and defend...
A growing roster? Are there going to be more? Threats.
Oh, yeah.
Because that would be dope. Now, are they going to be doing a live services route?
Comes on this journey with us, we're incredibly thrilled to announce that every new superhero and every new region will be delivered at no additional cost.
So there are going to be new playable characters. Who knows who could show up? Oh, yeah. Captain Marvel, Spider-Man... Wolverine.
So our promise to the community is that we won't have random loot boxes or pay-to-win scenarios.
Yeah.
But what about cosmetics?
This game represents a collaboration across Crystal Dynamics, Marvel Games, I know you're out here, Eidos Montreal, you guys are here, Nixie Software, our new Crystal Northwest studio, and everyone at Square Enix.
So we probably could be seeing Hawkeye in there after all.
So our game is about embracing your powers and living your superhero dreams. We have an exclusive gameplay demo in our booth that will show you more of the core campaign, its original story, and our superheroes in action.
So, Marvel's Avengers will release worldwide on PS4, Xbox One, Stadia, and PC. We got you covered. And we're excited to be partnering with PlayStation to bring some awesome surprises to the PlayStation audience. Including early beta access and unique benefits that we'll be revealing in the future. But before we go, we have one final glimpse into our world, including when you'll get to play this game.
Yes, get a release date.
This is what's next for the Avengers. Thank you, true believers.
Damn it. Progress, Hank.
I have a plan, but it's risky.
Hank, that doesn't look ready.
Come on, Tony, live a little.
Hank, like Hank Pym. It's Ant-Man. It's Giant Man, Ant-Man, Dr. Pym, whoever.
It worked.
It's sort of cute when they're small.
Ah, I didn't doubt you for a second, Hank.
Hank Pym. May 15th. Yes. Thankfully, I have Ultimate Alliance 3 to keep me tied over. We got one more reveal. Dragon Quest 11, Echoes of Ooze. That's all the stuff they got coming. They definitely knocked it out of the park this year. They made up for last year and then some. Thanks for joining me. I mean, Square Enix, I mean, I'm just so hyped about Avengers. Sacrifice Tier games are coming. They got so much heat coming this next year. So I probably won't do the... I might do the Ubisoft thing even later tonight. Like, I got a test to take for, a JOB interview, but I probably won't live stream the, we go to camera only. So I probably won't, I'm obviously not going to be able to live stream the Nintendo thing because there's going to be so much hype from that. And, And I'm going to be at work, and they're going to shoot showing in the morning, and I might do the... I'll let you know if I end up doing the live stream for Ubisoft tonight, but I'm probably going to do a pre-game thing on my website. But I think Square Enix, they definitely bought their big guns to this. So, anyway, y'all have a good night, and make sure you follow me on Twitter. Make sure you follow me on Twitch. I usually do. I'm gonna do a game stream this weekend, so I'll let you know what I play. Like usually, half hour before I get on. So I'm gonna hop off tonight. So you guys have a great week.